Good morning, Family Christian Center. So thrilled to have you with us, whether you're here in the building or out or online. Welcome today. What a beautiful Sunday morning here in Fort McMurray. Sun is shining and the warmth is not far behind. Going to be another great spring day that God has given us. And we're excited about today. Today we have titled our service Heritage Sunday, which I'll talk to you about in just a moment. First, if you are visiting, whether you're here in the building or out there online, special welcome to you. We would love to have you become part of our family and tell you all about what we're about. If you would like to connect with us, if you want to reach to the seat pocket in front of you, if you're here in the building, there's a little card that says Connect Card. It has a picture of a coffee cup on it. If you want to fill that out, bring it to the cafe in the foyer out here behind me. We'd love to give you just a free little drink or something to say thank you for coming. But more importantly, we're going to reach out during the week so that we can connect with you, let you know all the different things we got going on and how you can be involved and get to know some people. If you're out there online, you can do that at our website, familychristiancenter.org/connect. You can fill out that card and we will be sure to reach out this week and get to know you. What a great Sunday God has given us. Today is Heritage Sunday. So we're going to be going through some of the classic songs. We've got young people of all ages. Different people singing some specials. We got some great music coming your way. Just a great time to remember what God has done in our past and just to go through some of the messages that we've heard over the years. It's going to be a great time. We're also going to have some individuals come and read scripture with us. It's going to be a great time for us to just kind of ingest what God is saying to us through His Word. It's going to be a fantastic Sunday, so just be prepared to worship as we come this morning. I also want to encourage you, there's lots going on at Family Christian Center. Make sure to check out all our social media and our website for all the different events. I want to remind you, prayer every Sunday night, 6 p.m. Come on out for a night of prayer. Going to be a great time. Just connect with God's heart and with some other believers. For those looking to just build on the building blocks of their faith, whether you're new or you've been at it for a while, 4:30 here at the church is our foundations class with Pastor Riley. Come on out. Even if you haven't signed up, just come on out. He'll make sure to connect with you and get you a book. Great way to just kind of know the different scriptures and the things that kind of connect us to the basic Christian beliefs. I also want to let you know there's some summer camps. There's a junior high summer camp, a kids camp happening this summer. Go on our website, social media. You want to make sure to sign up those. They're going to be amazing events that you're not going to want to miss. Girlfriends, April 27th. There's going to be a simulcast event. You want to make sure to sign up for that. It's going to be a great time to get together with the ladies. Great teaching as well as time together. And then April 28th, 6 p.m., instead of our prayer service for this 1 week, we're going to have our annual general meeting. Just want to make sure to put that on your calendar. If you're a member, come on out. If you're non-member, you're welcome to come. Just can't participate in the voting, but we'd love for you to come and see what God has done this past year, but also what's coming down the pike. Very excited to be with you to worship today. We're going to be with us in a few moments. Just begin to prepare your heart for what God is going to do. Be blessed as you worship with us today as you watch these videos.
Pursue X is an 8-month program that Vanguard College offers in partnership with the local church. Grace and I have taken part in this program over the past year, and though this year is not yet over for us, Pursue X is an 8-month program that Vanguard College offers in partnership with the local church. Grace and I have taken part in this program over the past year, and though this year is not yet over for us, I have to say that this program has been filled with a lot of personal reflection and growth. So, what do students go through during Pursue X?
Students will go through an intentional discipleship program that's focused on introducing them to the foundations of Christian leadership, study and interpretation of the Bible, and discovery of their identity in Christ, all while gaining practical ministry experience as they serve in the context of their local church.
The beauty of this program is that it lets you stay plugged into your church family while receiving a real college-level Christian education.
So, if you're looking to attend Bible college, but you're not sure if you're ready to move away yet, we highly recommend the Pursue X program because it is a gap year with
a purpose and potential.
Hey, YMM youth. I'm Harmony.
And I'm Adelio. We are student leaders of FCC Youth. Do you enjoy thrifting and finding great deals on fashion items? Well, we have just a place for you to support.
We will be launching our very own online thrift shop with quality pieces at affordable prices. All profit will go towards supporting all our preteen and youth programs at Family Christian Center.
Follow us on Instagram at KingdomThriftsYMM. See what items we have listed on sale. You can see all the details on how to make your purchases, how to pick your items.
You can also donate your quality secondhand items as a way to support us. All donations have to be approved by Pastor Lisa. Again, you can follow our social media to find out how you can donate.
We appreciate all your prayers and support for this ministry. We can't wait to launch soon.
PursueX is an 8-month program that Vanguard College offers in partnership with the local church. Grace and I have taken part in this program over the past year, and though this year is not yet over for us, I have to say that this program has been filled with a lot of personal reflection and growth. So, what do students go through during PursueX?
Students will go through an intentional discipleship program that's focused on introducing them to the foundations of Christian leadership, study and interpretation of the Bible, and discovery of their identity in Christ, all while gaining practical ministry experience as they serve in the context of their local church.
The beauty of this program is that it lets you stay plugged into your church family while receiving a real college-level Christian education.
So, if you're looking to attend Bible college, but you're not sure if you're ready to move away yet, we highly recommend the Pursue X program because it is a gap year with
a purpose and potential.
I'm Harmony.
And I'm Adelio. We are student leaders of FCC Youth. Do you enjoy thrifting and finding great deals on fashion items? Well, we have just a place for you to support.
We will be launching our very own online thrift shop with quality pieces at affordable prices. All profit will go towards supporting all our preteen and youth programs at Family Christian Center.
Follow us on Instagram at KingdomThriftsYMM. See what items we have listed on sale. You can see all the details on how to make your purchases, how to pick your items.
You can also donate your quality secondhand items as a way to support us. All donations have to be approved by Pastor Issa. Again, you can follow our social media to find out how you can donate.
We appreciate all your prayers and support for this ministry. We can't wait to launch soon.
Good morning, FCC. We're so glad that you came out this morning. If you're able to, would you stand with us? We're going to worship the Lord today. And today is a special service. It's called Heritage Sunday. And our heritage is what we have inherited from the past, to value and to enjoy in the present, and to preserve and pass on to the future generations.
Lamentations 3, verse 21 to 24. Yet this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassion never fail. There are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion, therefore I will wait for him.
Psalms 33, verse 4 to 5. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of his unfailing love. Psalms 36, verse 5. Your love, Lord, reaches to the heavens. Your faithfulness to the skies. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 23 to 24. May God himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it.
Amen. Great
is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, so forever will be.
I forgot to mention, I just want to welcome those online, and if you are online and want to continue to connect to us, Family Christian Center, please go to our website, familychristiancenter.org, reach out to us, and we will certainly reach out to you. If you are new to church today, it's your first time, there's a little card in the seat pocket in front of you. If you fill that out with your name eligibly and your cell number and maybe your email address, we will reach out to you this week and someone will connect with you. So please don't go away saying that we didn't want to know you. We want to know you. Amen.
Yeah. Isn't it great to have the children on the stage and with us this morning? Praise the Lord for that. And an opportunity to commemorate, recognize our heritage, not only our family heritage, but our heritage in God and what God has done for us. And God, you know, we think just even this weekend and yesterday, especially when we think of our heritage, we think of the Jewish people and the nation of Israel and kind of renewed conflict in that region even yesterday. And so we were called to pray for the peace of Jerusalem and for the safety of the Jews, certainly. So God, can we pray to that end just this morning as we start? Oh God, we thank you for our heritage. God, we thank you for those in our family who have done the walk of faith. God, those who cared enough to teach us your ways. God, those who cared enough to tell us about you. And God, to lead us to faith in you. And God, we just we recognize the privilege that we have to do the same to our children and to our children's children, God. And we thank you for just the opportunity that we have to see the children worship and lead us in worship even today. And God, we also think of the Jewish people in the nation of Israel today. And God, we thank you for them. God, we know that they have a unique place in your message and in your history and even in your future as God, your perfect plan for the future of all people. So God, we pray for the peace of Jerusalem even now. And God, we just pray that for your wisdom in those who are involved in the region. God, we pray for the missionaries who are in the Middle East, God, that we are connected with. And God, we pray for their safety. God, we pray that you would give them hope, that you would encourage them. And God, above all, that you would give them peace. God, we just thank you for this opportunity that we have now to worship you, to commemorate and remember our heritage. And God, we just pray that all things this morning would be done to your honor and your glory. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated as we turn our attentions to our videos for this week.
Good day, everyone. My name is Marissa, and I am the Business and Facility Manager here at Family Christian Center. I'm here to bring you an important announcement as we prepare for our upcoming annual general meeting. On April 28th at 6 p.m., we would like to invite all formal church members to our annual general meeting. This event serves as a platform for us to come together as a church family, reflect on the past year, and discuss important matters for the future. We encourage all formal members to please place a date in your calendars and plan to be with us on April 28th. The annual general meeting is a crucial event for our church community as it allows us to share our vision and work towards a brighter future. We do require a quorum for the meeting to go ahead, so we kindly ask all formal church members to please make every effort to be with us. Together, let's continue to strengthen our church and make a positive impact in the lives of our community. We look forward to seeing you there.
The gospel is reaching all generations, and conferences like this are reaching and catering to everyone.
We're all women seeking God.
The worship is inspiring. It's powerful.
It's just very uplifting. God is present, and he's there for people to receive him and hear his word.
The Bible is living, God's living word, so it's speaking to all of us at different places.
The teaching here has been saturated in the word, just faithful and true to the scriptures.
A body of believers, both the local church that you're a part of, and then look how big this is, that corporate body to come together.
Personally, it feels like the closest thing to heaven.
We are all sisters in Christ. God is here and we're learning and we're growing. And yes, he's drawing people from all over. So it's beautiful to see.
Hey, Fort McMurray, my name is Zon.
And I'm Catalin. We have some exciting news to share with you. Starting July 15th to July 18th, FCC Youth will be hosting a local summer camp for students going into grades 7, 8, and 9. So that would be students between the ages of 11 and 14.
The camp will be located at Family Christian Center. The times will be from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. every single day.
Early bird registration costs $125 per student and officially opens on Sunday, March 31st until Saturday, June 15th.
Regular price registration will cost $150 per student from Sunday, June 16th until Monday, July 15th. To register or volunteer, visit familychristiancenter.org/youth.
We are accepting volunteers who are going into grade 10 or older. We would love your support in making this camp successful. Contact Pastor Isa for any questions at 780-607-0691.
Thank you for your time and have a blessed day.
Promises of God. Joshua 23:14. Now I am about to go the way of all the earth. You know with all your heart and soul that not one of all the good promises the Lord your God gave you has failed. Every promise has been fulfilled. Not one has failed. Psalm 33:11. But the plans of the Lord stand firm forever, the purposes of his heart through all generations. 2 Corinthians 1:20. For no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through him, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God. 2 Corinthians 6:16 and 18. What agreement is there between the temple of God and idols? For we are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will live with them and walk among them, and I will be their God, and they will be my people. And I will be a father to you, and you will be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty.
Can you please sing with me? I believe everybody knows this song.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I'm living just because. sweet to hold our newborn baby and feel the pride and joy he gives. But greater still,
some of our youth that's going to sing promises for us. faithfulness. Amen. Hallelujah. Can I get an amen? Great is his faithfulness. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have one of our beautiful singers, Joanne, that's coming to lead us in worship.
Praise the Lord, oh my.
You know that truth is for those who stand redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. And if today you're here and you don't know Jesus, we're inviting you to make him the Lord and Savior of your life. It is well with, and then it will be well with your soul. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. God bless you. They don't ask me to speak. All right, so we're going to invite our next, where are you? Come on up. There he is. Isn't he gorgeous? Praise the Lord. Fernando will read for us.
Psalms 42. He lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. Psalms 89:2. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you have established your faithfulness in heaven itself. Psalms 93:5, your statutes, Lord, stands firm. Holiness adorns your house for endless days. 2 Corinthians 1:21-22, now it is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. He anointed us, set his seal of ownership on us, and puts the Spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. Ephesians 6:14-15, stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, for the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with readiness that comes from the gospel of peace.
Thank you. Church in our family. Your hands. nobody can tear it down, what God has built. Amen. Clementina, go ahead.
Matthew chapter 16, verse 24 and 25. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it. But whoever loses their life for me would find it." Acts chapter 2, verse 23. "This man was handed over to you by God's deliberate plan and foreknowledge, and you, with the help of wicked men, put him to death by nailing him to the cross." Acts chapter 10, verse 36 to 40. "You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, announcing the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout the province of Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witnesses of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a cross, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen." 1 Corinthians 1, verse 18. "For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God." Hebrews 12, verse 2. "Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith, for the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down on the right hand of the throne of God." 1 Peter 2, 24. "He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we might die to sin and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed."
No, Psalm 18, verse 46. The Lord lives, praise to be my rock, exalted be God my Savior. Psalm 28, verse 7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and he helps me. My heart leaps for joy, and with my song I praise him. Psalm 101-5. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Psalm 146, 1 and 2. Praise the Lord, my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. 1 Peter 1, 3. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead.
To Calvary, where Jesus
that was involved this morning. So our dancers, our kids singers, our scripture readers, if you would come and just come to the platform quickly, please. We're going to do this next song. And some of you didn't practice with us, but that's okay. We're still going to do it. Amen. I just thought we should end this worship time together by singing one of the, it's actually more modern than, come right in front, kids, okay? Come on up, good job. Aren't they wonderful? Aren't they fabulous? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, and you guys can move out too. Move up. Good. So we've got young, the young ones, the preteen ones, and we've got the youth. We've got some young adults, and from there, I'm just not going to point out anything. Thank you. Praise the Lord.
Oh. could continue to stand and just praise the Lord today. Father, we thank you because you're always great and you will forever be, Lord. And we declare, Lord, that this week that we will go with your greatness, just going, preceding us in everything that we do, Lord. We declare, Lord, that everything that we're going to take and do this week will be victorious, God, because you promised to go before us, and you will supply everything that we will need today. And so, Father, today we lift up our hands to declare your glory and your praise that always belongs to you. In your name we pray, amen and amen.
God bless you. Have a wonderful week. We have prayer tonight at 6 p.m. Then sings my song.